My name is Giacomo Fontana, and this is the results of my master thesis, for which I developed a semi-automatic method to detect and extract complex polar moment from high-resolution multispectral satellite image. A very long title. The aim of my project were two. On one end, I wanted to semi-automatically detect new burials. On the other hand, I wanted to automatically draw existing datasets. Indeed, across the Arabian Peninsula, there are hundreds of thousands of burial monuments, from the Oman to Jordan, everywhere. And a lot of them have been studied according to the spatial distribution to detect the dynamics of human occupation. But the studies, actually, there are many studies now, have been based on the detection of the burials with a point in a shapefile and other characteristics, morphological characteristics, like the area, the perimeter, the diameter, that will only be collected in the field. At the opposite, I wanted to also create a tool that was able to automatically draw them and then extract those characteristics and import them in JS for all types of studies. The area that I investigate for my master thesis is in the area of Soha, in the Sultanate of Oman. It is in the southeastern part of the Arabian Peninsula. I had satellite image for 1,000 square kilometers, but I used only 100 square kilometers for my thesis. The area is characterized by a series of mountain ridges that delimit the Wadi Valley, it is an old riverbed. On the north, there is an alluvial plain, while on the south, a series of plateaus. I used 3 square kilometers as a training area where I trained the ruleset. And I used eCognition to do everything. And as a test area, 100 square kilometers. The data are indeed both YouTube satellite image that have a resolution of 0.5 meter on the ground for the 100 band, and while for the multispectral, I have 8 band at 2 meters. The preprocessing has been limited to spatial preprocessing and fine sharpening algorithm, and quick atmospheric correction for the spectral processing. The burial monument that I'm investigating are stone-made structures. They are normally circular, but they can be elliptic, oval, a horseshoe shape also. And they are made of the same material of the surrounding environment. They can occur also in cluster. And as you can see in this picture, we have here the two main types of burial monument that we can detect from satellite. Therefore, the classic circular object and very complex clusters. The cluster are actually simple composition of one or more burials, one close to the other. And of course, they are quite challenging to detect because you cannot generalize a shape for them. The approach that I developed is based on two steps. On the first one, I went to identify a series of candidate objects through the identification of a candidate pixel. Then I create the object, then I define the border that I want to draw the object, and then I classify the object as a real kern or as another type of object. Candidate object identification. Here I use two types of template matching. They're actually the same template matching but for two aims. On one end I wanted to detect isolated cairns, on the other the clusters. Here I use for the isolated cairn, I use 100 training samples, and from them I generate 3 templates that I apply each of them 4 times with data of 90 degrees. For the clusters, I use only 30 training samples because in the training area there was a less number of clusters indeed. It's important to say that the conceptualization behind the use of the template matching is different. Indeed, if in one end, for the isolated cairns, I wanted to detect the entire object and then the circular shape as a final feature of the final object, here I choose to try to detect only a section of the cluster that is equal to one of the single cairns that compose the cluster. You can see indeed in the template generated that there is the two extremities, there are the two extremities of a cluster and a middle section. Here you can see some results of the template matching. You can see on the image on the right that there is a cluster. This cluster is composed of 14 cairns. The template matching was able to detect only 4 of them, but this is enough. Indeed, from using the drawing process that we explain in a bit, the process is able to automatically define the border and draw the border of the entire cluster, and it is just enough to add one seed pixel to the classifier, the entire burial as a possible candidate. Object creation. Here I use two types of multi-resolution segmentation, or two types of segmentation. The first one is a multi-resolution segmentation. Here the aim was to create very compact object around 10 pixel size, like 2.5 square meter, but more than that one, to create objects with a very strong spectral similarities of the pixel that compose them, then with a very strong homogeneous spectrum. This is extremely important for the next step. It is a region growing segmentation based on spectral difference. Here, every object is going to increase and match neighboring objects at the base of their similarities of the spectrum. And this process is repeated infinite time up to when it found a very strong spectral difference between the object itself and the neighboring objects. And this spectral difference is composed by the border of the cairns, in this case, by the border of the burials. And then it is able to draw in a very satisfactory way the entire object. I simplify the object, and I just identify as a candidate object all the objects that share one or more pixel, the side of the pixel, with the candidate pixel. It's very simple. You can see that large part of the background area was classified as a candidate. Indeed, this is the result of the error of the template matching. Indeed, there were some candidate pixels identified on anomalies in the background area. And the region growing segmentation, as a result of the region growing segmentation, this object went to increase their size, merging neighboring object almost to cover the entire background area. Because there was not the same spectral differences that you can find with the border of the cairns of the burials. Then I just exploited this phenomenon using a very simple size-based classification, and then just classify all the objects that have a very large area. And in particular, I took the largest known cluster in the entire regional study, not only the study area, and with an area increase of 25%. At the end, I apply a series of object reshaping algorithms that are just going to locally redraw the border of the object in order to better define the border itself. It's important to say that the entire process of drawing can be exported and used for other types of archaeological objects. And in that case, I will use only the true segmentation and the object reshaping. Because, for example, to automatically draw the shape files that I had, I use only this, and then because I already know that are for sure burials because they were detected through this identification. Object classification. In the last step, I use a very simple series of apples to tree sort classification and a random tree classifier. The absolute result are actually optional, you just not use them. But I found them useful just to decrease the number of candidates. Here I use the BAI that is built up index to classify a series of objects like roads, for example, brightness, and the NDVI. The NDVI that I use to classify a large number of trees that, due to their shape, circular shape, and similar size, were erroneously classified as a possible candidate. At the opposite, the random tree classifier did the big part of the work. Here, I train it with 130 positive samples that are the same samples that I used to train the template matching. And then 200 negative samples. The negative samples have been taken from the four main geomorphological area present in the region, that are the plain, the wadi, then the old riverbed in the middle, the mountain ridges, and the plateau. I did that to represent the type of most positive the target area, but also because being the cairns made of the material that you can find the surrounding, this way I also did the good representations of the possible cairns. The results. Oh, I'm quite fast. The detection. In the training area, that is equal to 3 square kilometer, I detected 188 objects. And of them, 167 were true positive. That are equal to almost 90% of the total object verifying the field through ground routing. And I had an index of 11% of false positive. In the test area, that is 100 square kilometer, that is much larger than the 3 square kilometer of the training area, I had 1,223 detections. Of them, 852 were true positive, that are equal to almost 80% of the total burial monument identifying the area through ground routing, with an index of around 30% of false positive. The detection here was both for the isolated cairns and the clusters. If we compare the results with the other study for the detection of burials in Arabia, it is shorter. It detected only, it's important to say that this process was aimed to detect only the what I call isolated cuts, then the simple shape one. We can see that in the scenario where they had the most similar opportunity index of true positive, in order to detect 62 true positive, they went to detect 22,179 false positive. And therefore, it is a, you know, I'm sure the index of true positive is quite good, and it's not applicable to just run the process across the region, because there will be too many false positive, and also the labor necessary to review all of them, it will be really big. Yeah, I'd like to show you something that I found very interesting. This is an example of false positive. You can see a series of dots, a series of circles that are that could resemble the cans. They are actually the results of food dumpster activities. Indeed, in the area there's been a growing urbanization, and actually there are series of food dumpster that are growing to clean the surface, in order to prepare the surface indeed for the construction of a road. From an archaeological point of view, they are very different from what we are looking for. But if we try to describe them with technical keys of interpretation, we can see how they can be described with the same keys used to describe the ruler monuments. Because they are stone in structure, they are circular, and also the size are the same. And therefore, it's very interesting because I'm not even sure that an automatism can discern if they are pile of stones or cans that are actually pile of stones. And at the same time, a possible solution could be the use of the context. Then another the classifier based on the context, and then if there are these kind of strips, they classify them as a candidate object. At the same time, the false negative is a major part of the false negative. Was due to cans that really blend with the surrounding landscape. At the same time, they have also a little bit of different dynamic geomorphological area that they didn't consider in the first instance. It's interesting to note how the drawing process, when I identified them as a curve, the drawing process was still able to, I think, in a very satisfactory way, define their border and then automatically draw them. Talking about the drawing process, here you can see a series of cans that have been automatically detected and drawn by the process. And of course, everything is georeferenced, and that you can just export it on JS and then, you know, do your spatial analysis and extrapolate more information from that. You can see that the process is able to draw quite different shapes between one and another. And therefore, we go from the first one that is the classic, from the first one that is the classic circular cans to other types. And in in a very satisfactory way. And because actually the drawing process is not dependent on the shape or on that type of feature, but only on the spectral homogeneity of the ruler itself, of the object that we are looking for. For this reason, I try to apply it also to other, I'm now actually applying to other types of archaeological context. In particular, I'm using drone picture, like photogrammetry, and I'm trying to automatically draw the stratigraphic unit. And it's still working in a very satisfactory way, I think. To conclude, that the feature of the method, the method is able to use satellite imaging. That is a little bit different from LIDAR. What we are seeing in the last video is a growing interest for LIDAR. But for large part of the real peninsula, we have no such type of data, and it's not even likely to have that type of data soon. Also because the Boreas a lot of time are in the middle of the desert. Therefore, there is that necessity for LIDAR in that regard. At the same time, during the last couple of years, there has been a really growing phenomenon of destruction of the burial, both for looting activities, but also for increasing urbanization. And the method is a really fortunate detection application, actually, because I applied it on the image of 2013, of image actually of burial that had been destroyed in the meantime, because, just to show you, here there is now a highway is moving in this direction, then a large part of the burials have been destroyed. And we can apply the same method to image of 2008, for example, to automatically detect what has been destroyed and maybe also monitoring it. At the same time, everything is fully georeferenced, and you can export the data in JS and other type of analysis, like spatial analysis. Moreover, the method is quite effective both to detect individual burials and also clusters, then object with a very complex shape. It is true that in order to detect a cluster, I exploit the thing that they are made of objects with a regular shape. I'm now trying to apply the same approach to triangular objects in order to detect only one angle. Then the idea is to detect the angle and automatically draw the entire triangular object and then classify it. Of course, I need training samples for new burials and also for geomorphological areas. And finally, the last feature is the drawing process. Now I would like to rewrite it because the drawing process is made of two types of segmentation that are common, and for a series of simple reshaping algorithms. It can be rewritten in MATLAB, for example, and then make more easy to use because now everything at the moment is implemented in eCognition. For the future, I would like, if I will have a continue this work with Fabizi, I would like to extend the study area with the remaining use the remaining 900 square meter for which I already have some light image. But at the same time, I would like to take other study area across the Arabian Peninsula and then to have a better repertoire of different type of cairns and also geomorphological areas. And of course, I'm quite interested in the use of convolutional neural network. In particular, I'm now playing a little bit. In Incognition, actually, since December, they also implement a convolutional neural network. But the idea is to use to move on from Incognition. And the idea is to use a convolutional neural network instead of the template matching. And then to identify candidate that actually will potentially automatically draw. With this one, I would like to conclude. And of course, if you have any feedback, they are really welcome. And thank you so much for your attention.